Hi, I'm Darren Rose. In this video, I'll go through some of the basics of loudspeaker placement and how to get the best out of your system. Though the perception of sound quality is a subjective thing, a high-quality loudspeaker design and correct attention to placement are the foundations to start with. The purpose of listening at home is enjoyment, whereas the purpose of professional listening is to use the loudspeaker as a sound quality control tool, so the starting point is very different. However, there are certain basics that are necessary to consider when placing the loudspeaker at home. Small details that can have a great effect on the end result performance. The following examples are applicable to pretty much all loudspeakers in the world, regardless of brand and model. At home, it's very typical to place the loudspeakers very close to a wall or other hard surface, even in a corner. What happens sound-wise when loudspeakers are placed close to a wall is that lower frequencies, the bass level, increases and there's lots of extra bass in the sound. This can even double when the speaker is in the corner. Simply put, this happens because low frequencies are radiated from the speaker in every direction, not only forwards. When the sound waves go back and hit the wall, some bounce back to the listening position. It's easy to think that by moving the loudspeakers away from the wall, you can reduce the bass level and solve the problem. In fact, this isn't a recommended solution at all, since the distance to the back wall will cause other problems which are even harder to fix. On our website, genelec.com, there's a lot of detailed information about this back wall cancellation phenomenon. So what do we do to deal with this increased bass level? Well, each Genelec loudspeaker includes a way of calibrating to compensate for the increased bass level. And with a speaker like the 6040R, there are in fact two ways of doing it. Either with a computer and GLM software, or by using the dip switches on the bottom of the speaker. When you tilt the speaker down gently, you can see the dip switches on the bottom. It's possible to adjust the bass level down in 2 decibel steps, -2, -4, or 6, or cut the lowest bass with the low bass dip switch. It's up to you to decide what needs to be done, but as a starting point, if the wall behind the loudspeaker is very hard, like concrete, then probably a -4 or -6 dB tilt will be needed. There's also the low bass tilt as well. If the wall behind the speaker isn't that solid, then probably -2 dB is enough to reduce the bass and bring some clarity back to the sound. After making any changes, it's always good to use some time to get used to the updated sound. Taking the bass level down will bring clarity to the mid-range and bring out details that you couldn't hear before. This is especially noticeable with the human voice. You'll know it's right when it sounds natural, not too bassy or boomy. It's good to remember that you're always listening to the combination of the loudspeakers and the room. If the room is full of hard surfaces, there will be lots of reverberation in the sound. Adding soft materials or even acoustic panels helps to reduce the reverberation in the room. And the further you move from the speakers, the more you hear the room reflections compared to the original sound reproduced by the speakers. So in a nutshell, it's good to place the loudspeakers close to the wall as long as the extra bass level is reduced in the speaker settings. Too heavy bass will mask the low mid frequencies and human talking is harder to understand. It's easy to notice when you're watching the news, for example. And the same goes with music and movies. Taking away the extra bass makes it possible for you to hear the details of the recording much better. There's a separate video about making these settings in the GLM software. If you're interested in the subject, please have a look and dive deeper into the secrets of calibrating your speakers. And by adding soft materials like carpet, curtains, or acoustic panels, it can help to reduce reverberation in the room. The difference is often easily noticeable, even without any music from the speakers.